Hello, praise the Lord. God is good that has given us another moment, another opportunity to interact with His Word. And I come as someone who is a messenger of the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am the Very Reverend Eridad Shissa, the Vicar and Subdean of St. Andrew's Cathedral. I come to share with you the events of the Holy Week. Holy Week, the week that celebrates our Lord Jesus Christ when He was winding up His earthly ministry of the 3 years when He arrived here. And so Holy Week events show us His finishing line, how He offered Himself, remember, as a living sacrifice, a sacrifice that takes away the sins of the world. And so these events are very, very important in the life of a Christian believer. And so I take time to interact with you on the 7 days of Jesus's final week. Now, the time that I'm talking about is the one that kickstarts on a day called Palm Sunday. Palm Sunday is the day that commemorates Jesus's triumphant entry into Jerusalem. And this we read Matthew chapter 21, verse 1, and the Bible talks about Jesus winding up His work. But He first comes and enters Jerusalem in power. And the people cut tree branches, commonly known as palm leaves, and they spread them on the road. And the same text is covered by St. John chapter 12, verse 12, following. And John is the one that mentions palm leaves, and people spread them and welcome the Lord Jesus Christ into Jerusalem, and they shout commonly a song called Hosanna to the King, Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. And so they sing that, welcoming the Lord Jesus Christ. And in power and in victory, Jesus enters. And the Bible says Jesus enters Jerusalem riding on a donkey, a lowly animal, like we have attended Palm Sunday services. They enumerate the things that actually people did, spreading their cloaks on the road, and people welcoming Him in power, thinking that they were welcoming an earthly king. But the Lord Jesus' ministry, the Lord Jesus' ministry meant something different. He was coming as a spiritual leader. And so in this Holy Week, Sunday, which is commonly called Palm Sunday, is day one. And people welcome Him. And so the Lord Jesus Christ on this day goes on into the temple, looks at what is happening around. And the Bible says Jesus retired and went to His friend's home. And these friends are known to have been three. This is Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha. And so Jesus retired there that evening. He never did anything, but He just looked around. And so it teaches us that sometimes there are certain times when God can be inspecting something, looking for something, but He just inspects and keeps quiet about it. And you might have prayed about something, expecting God to do something, but He inspects and keeps and skips that day, only to come back the following day. And that is day number two, which is called Monday in the Holy Week. And this Holy Week Monday is a very important day because Jesus comes back. As we read Matthew 21, verse 12 to 22, and then we read the same in Mark 11:15, we read the same in Luke 19:45, that Jesus comes and He does the cleaning of the temple. Actually, He purifies. This is when Matthew says that He finds people exchanging money, people shouting, people turning the house of prayer into a den of robbers. And so Jesus does mention that, hey, stop making my house a house of prayer. And in Matthew chapter 21, Verse 13, the Bible says, it is written, so Jesus tells them, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you have made it into a den of thieves. And you know, the temple was meant for that purpose, but people had misused the temple. And of course, as Christians, we read about the temple, and there are two Bible portions that I want to mention about. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16, Paul says and asks the question and says, do you not know that you are the temples of God, that the Spirit of God dwells in you? And so when Jesus comes and cleanses the temple in our times, and actually the interpretation, when you talk about the temple being us, being our bodies, then Jesus is saying, don't you know that your body, don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, and the temple and the Holy Spirit of God dwells in you? And so when Jesus cleansed the temple, actually it comes to us that actually when he comes on in into our lives, there's something fresh, there's something good, there's something wonderful that he does. He does the cleansing. He chases away all those things that we read about in, like we read in Galatians 5:19, when Paul enumerates those dirty things. And so Jesus does the cleaning, does the cleaning. And so the point I'm making here on this Holy Week Monday is that Jesus is zealous to purify us. And so my brother, my sister, Jesus, when Jesus comes on in into your life, he does the cleaning, he does the purification, and is more zealous to do that. And so this Holy Week, I invite you that when Jesus comes on in into your life, he does something great. He does work for you, cleaning, and he does it immediately well. And remember, on this same day, Jesus finds a tree, leafy, and no fruit. And he does the cursing of that tree. And according to what they tell us about the fig trees, when they shed their leaves, first thing that comes on is, before the leaves return, is a fruit. Now, fruits return first, and then the leaves, when the leaves come, the fruits are already there. So Jesus expected a fruit on this tree. But listen to me, he didn't find any fruit. And so Jesus curses the tree. And now in our lives, my brothers and sisters, we shouldn't attract a curse from God. God expects us to bear fruit, and fruit that lasts. And like we read in Isaiah chapter 5, a fruit that is not bitter, a fruit that is not sour. And of course, after that one also attracts a curse. And Jesus Christ mentions the word, and the tree dries, withers. And that was the end of it all. And the disciples were amazed with what happened. And so my brothers and sisters, this is very, very important. And then on Tuesday, Jesus goes to the Mount of Olives. And this one gives us a lengthy talk, a teaching that Jesus gives about very many things. Remember the story of the two boys, the sons, the parable of the two sons, one obedient, one disobedient, but eventually they were differentiated by their actions. And so Jesus teaches us in that parable, that discourse on Mount Olives, and it's a wonderful teaching. And that one, you read Matthew chapter 21, verses 23 onwards, actually almost up to chapter 26, and Jesus gives a discourse. This is where he talks about the wicked servants in the vineyard. He talks about these things that we read in Matthew chapter 25 about the fools, the foolish girls and the wise girls, and then the separation of the goats and the sheep. All those things Jesus teaches them on during the Holy Week. And so, brethren, shall we concentrate on reading these things so that this season does not just bypass us, but it passes with a blessing, leaving a blessing to us, because Jesus is zealous to purify us. And this is actually very, very important. And a Wednesday is called a Holy Wednesday. It is a quiet Wednesday. It is called a spy Wednesday, because actually this is the day that actually Judas Iscariot was trying to, Judas Iscariot was trying to plot how he could how he could hand over Jesus Christ to them. And this is what happened. And so Wednesday, Jesus stayed at his friend's place. Sunday evening, he went to Lazarus, Mary, and Martha's place. Monday evening, he went Martha, Lazarus, and Mary's place. They were the friends. And so I got a challenge today that if Jesus visited around in life, in body, if he walked around, would I, Eridad Milton Shissa, attract him to come and visit me and stay with me overnight? Lazarus and his sisters attracted Jesus because actually they had nurtured a relationship with him. And so for all of you and for all of us that actually nurture our relationship with Jesus Christ, we attract him to come and he stays with us. And so friends, God is good that actually he gives us this opportunity to learn together. And Monday, Thursday is the day number 5 when Jesus actually eats the Last Supper with his disciples and gives them a mandatory statement called the greatest commandment, love one another. That's the mandatum, and that's what we are looking up to for Monday, Thursday, and Jesus actually eats with them and gives them a fellowship that actually all of us need to fellowship with one another and doing a lowly service of as servants in the house of the Lord. And so, and all those we read, Matthew 26, John chapter 13, and it specifies our servanthood in the house of the Lord. And then number six is the trial on Good Friday. And of course, you know what happened on Good Friday. He was crucified, he was buried, and on Saturday was quiet, because actually, he was deep down there doing ministry. When you read Matthew, he tells us that actually he went down there to release the captives and set them free. And so friends, Jesus comes to set us free from the agonies of sin and only to rise up on Sunday morning. And that is what he does for us, my brothers and sisters. So may God, who is our Father, who sent his Son Jesus Christ to come, and this Holy Week is compacted with a lot of activity, all of it gearing towards the salvation of man, salvation of us as sinners. And so we ask the Lord God to dwell within us, remembering that this Holy Week is showing us that Jesus is zealous, and the reason why Luke tells us about his Gethsemane story, where he sweated actually until it was blood dropping. And for who? It's for you and for me. So brethren, remember, God loves you. God loves me. This Holy Week testifies to us that God is looking for a sinner. And when it comes to looking for a sinner, nothing crosses Jesus' face. Actually, he is determined to save you, to save me. The reason why he ended up on the cross. I just want to thank God for this opportunity that he has given us to think through. And please read on Matthew chapter 21 on up to the finishing line. And that's chapter 28. You'll see what God has for you. And by the way, those chapters are long, because every detail of whatever happened there was very important, that they recorded every bit of it. And so may God, who sent his Son Jesus Christ to save us, be with you. And may he be with me to save you and save me. That at the end, we shall be a people that will inherit the kingdom, because Jesus has gone to prepare places for us. And this Holy Week is testimony to add to that, that actually we are on the journey. So don't look back. Focus on the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. So says the writer of Hebrews chapter 12. So may God bless you, my brothers and sisters. Stay well and keep well during the Easter period. May God bless you to die with him and rise up with him in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.